Today I'll share with you a personal incident that happened between me and my stepfather. Okay. I've never had a proper relationship with my father, stepfather, father, whatever. I always thought he was my father. But later on, when I was, I think, 13, 14, my mother told me he's my stepfather. It kind of broke my heart, but, you know, I guess we just move on. So I knew that he's my stepfather. But things never worked out. He was always beating me, hitting me, abusing his powers as a father. And so I left home many times. And then finally, when I got a job, I earned my freedom and I never wanted to stay at home. Okay. So even though I started to work from the age of, like, staying away from the house full time, from the age of 20 onwards, I stayed out full time here and there. Sometimes when things are not working well, come back sometime. But it was permanently stay out. So after I stayed out and doing my own thing, living my own life, I always had the thing in my heart, always had that thing that I wanted to patch things up between my father and my mother, my stepfather and father, my mother. Always wanted to patch things up. Always wanted to have like a family. Believe it or not, I tried my level best. I would take them out for a movie. I would take them out for TGIF. I would take them out for lunches or dinners, or sometimes I'd come home. No matter what I did, I still felt, you know, it was kind of missing. That bond was missing. In fact, whenever I would bring up the fact that my father hit me and abused me as a child, he physically hit me and all, his response was that, today you have become a better human being because I beat you. Because he considers it beating is actually abuse. Okay? I mean, beating is discipline, like a hit or a slap on the buttocks. But hitting with a rubberized kind of bamboo cane, a thin one, until your blood would come out, that's not discipline. You would hit me so much that my skin would puncture and blood would actually come out. Okay, or with a belt, all that. Okay, so it was always there, these memories. Beating me up for 45 minutes, 30 minutes, non-stop. And there was never any good memories. Whenever I would see these television serials, the boy sitting with his dad and talking, or the sitting on the lap, I never had that. Okay. So now, I wanted to make peace. So one day, I remember going to, this is at the age of, I think, 30, 31 or 32, whatever. I remember going to my parents' house. They were staying in Sharjah. It was called the Burj 2000, that building, Burj 2000. I don't know if the name has changed. It's near the, those of you who stay in UAE, it's near the General Post Office roundabout in Rola. So they were staying there. I had my Lexus RX 330 four-wheel drive. So I parked it, went up to have food. And that time, you know, this girl was in my life, the one whose face is tattooed here. Okay. I went to talk to my father and mother about marriage. And I really wanted to get married to her and that time. So I went to talk to them and we were talking, we were sitting and having food, and I said, I'd like to talk to you. And so they're like, okay, fine. My mom told my stepdad he wants to talk something important. So he sat at, you know, the head of the table, and my mom was sitting here, I was sitting here. My mom bought some food and something to drink, juice or something. tea with milk and sugar. So we are sitting and talking, and I was talking to my mom and dad that I want to get married to this girl, I'm in love with this girl, and you know, I want a family life, and you know, those typical conversations you have. So I was telling my stepfather, and I was saying I want to be a man of the house, and I guess I wanted to talk to my family and tell them this. Now, before I go further, I want you to visualize you talking to your mom and dad about being a man of the house or taking up responsibility and all that. A normal parent would say, congratulations, good, I'm glad you're taking responsibility. You know, even if you're not convinced, but at least extend a hand of support. Okay. My stepfather, after I told him this, he was nodding his head. He looked up, and I still can't forget what he said. He said, I'm paraphrasing, not the exact word for word, because it was 15 years ago. He said, you and man, he laughed, and so when he laughed, I was like, what? Huh? Like, for me, it suddenly, I just popped out of that bubble where I was talking. I was like, why, what happened? And then he looks up again and gives me this sarcastic look. Law, you'll never be a man. Okay? You have the guts to be a man? And mind you, this is from a guy who had lost his job, I think. By that time, it was 10 years or so, he was unemployed. He was on a visa that my mother took out. My mother was working and looking after the house. He used to stay at home and assist her. So this guy was without a job himself. He couldn't get a job. And he was not earning anything. My mom was earning. So he's telling me, you have the guts to be a man. What man you are? Saying, he's saying, my nickname was Lavi, L-A-V-I. He was like, Lavi, you are something, he said, you can't be a man, you're not a man, or something very condescending and insulting. When you're a man, you talk to me, or something like that. I'll tell you, my blood was already boiling, because I was not only shocked, I was, what the fuck are you? So then I told him, like, and he was giving this really rude, sarcastic, insulting answer. He's saying, you, what man? I said, what the fuck are you talking, man? Straight away I said, what are you talking? What the fuck are you blabbering? Like, I'm talking to you proper, and this is what shit you have to say. So he said, I can talk. Something he said, I can talk, but I will not. And he laughed again or something. I lost it. I was like, you bastard. I don't know. Are you some real, I said, son of a bitch or something like that? I said, motherfucker or something. I said, fucking hit you right now and show you what fucking man I am. And he said, what you will do? You can do? I was, obviously my blood was boiling, and my mother realized it's getting out of control. Immediately she stood up, she came in between me, and we both are sitting down, not that I was standing up. And she said, my father's name is Frederick Pinto. So she said, Peddy. His name is like Freddy. They say, instead of Freddy, they say Peddy. Peddy, stop. She said in our language, hey, stop, what are you? And she said, Lavi, she said, Lavi, my name. Stop, you know, both of you stop. What are you both acting? And then she was like, she told my stepfather to get up. Go inside. This is what nonsense. What you both are talking like children. And she took it. I was so fucking pissed. I was like, I told mom, I said, fucking kill him, the bastard. I was boiling. I said, fucking kill him, fucking loser. He's sitting and eating your money and talking like a dog. I gave him, I don't think he gave a fuck about it. Oh, fuck. And then I left off. So fucking disgusted. You know, so why am I sharing this? See, these memories, no? These memories and moments, you never forget. It remains etched into your mind and heart, you know. And you'll always think about it. That's one of the reasons why I cannot forget, accept this man. I don't like this man at all. That's the reason why, even if he were going to die, I wouldn't feel sorry for him one bit. If he were, I actually want him to suffer, which I've told you, I want him to suffer the most painful death. And I know this might sound very evil, but I'll take a great amount of pleasure seeing him suffer. Because he's such a horrible human being. And the thing that baffles me the most, he doesn't have an iota of regret. He doesn't have a bit of remorse. He still justifies what he did. Seriously, he just justifies. I'll give you another 2-3 stories maybe later. Today, I don't want to give you an overdose. But this incident, fuck, what a human being, man. So that is why when I look at him, my blood boils. I've tried my level best over the years. I have tried. I'll tell you, even after my baby was born, I let them talk to my baby. But then again, I was like, fuck, you can't forget it, man. It keeps coming back. These human beings, you know, that's why I tell people, no? If you try to convince your parents or you try to change them, you will fail. You can't. After a certain point of time, you just can't. The guy's a fucking loser, man. Fuck, I hate him. He's lucky that his son is taking care of him. Yeah, that is my stepbrother. Fuck, I'll tell you, if he was dying on the street right now, I wouldn't even urinate to give him water. Is that much of a fucking animal? Can't stand him. Can't stand him at all. I know you'll say forgive, forget and this and that. And you can say whatever you want because you are not... You didn't have to go through 30 years of pain, torture, insults, humiliation. And I'm sorry, I'm not one of the Mahatma Gandhi or holier than thou. Oh, he lost 60 years of his life. He got out and forgave. Oh, forgiveness and hug. I'm sorry, I don't want to be that. I don't want to be a Jesus Christ and be hung on the cross and people look up and, oh, he's so great. No, fuck you. It's not going to... I know some of you will say, though, the negativity will get to you. I use it to drive me, man. I use it to make me focused. I enjoy the pain. I enjoy the anger. It makes me fucking alert, man. The main thing which I want to tell you through this is, you know, your parents, your upbringing impacts you a lot. It does impact you a lot. These scars, wounds and pains remain with you forever. No matter how hard you try, it remains with you. Anyway, I just wanted to share this. Maybe in some other video, I'll share 2-3 other incidents. You'll be shocked if I tell you each episode of my life. It's like a horror movie, you know. It's like one of those movies. Fuck, can a human being be so bad? You will not believe if I tell you some of the stories. They are that bad, you know. So, but yeah. No matter what happens, no matter what you go through life, yes, to a certain point, it does impact you. But then you need to take charge and say, it happened. I can't give excuses of my past to justify my behavior for the future. And you need to move on. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. So, let me know your thoughts. And, you know, I'm not asking you to call him bad words and this and that. Anyway, he's not going to read. So, but feel free. You can say whatever you want. You can say I'm to blame or he is to blame. You can give your comments. It's not that he's going to read, ever going to read. He doesn't watch my YouTube channel. Not in touch with him also. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. All right. Please take care. This is me signing off. Chill.